2022 will go down as one of the craziest years on record.
Peace on our continent has been shattered.
Homes to 11 years, 3 months.
Crypto obviously right now getting crushed.
Tech imploded, wiping out trillions of dollars in value. Elon agreed, then reneged, then bought Twitter again. And we saw possibly the most insane fraud of all time in FTX. So what comes next? Will tech come roaring back? Will crypto die off forever? It's hard to believe, but 2023 will be even crazier than last year. I'm a Silicon Valley-based venture capitalist, and part of my job is to anticipate the next big thing. Here's my predictions for the 10 biggest things we have to pay attention to in 2023. Starting with FTX, which set off a chain reaction in crypto. We saw coin value plummet immediately. Billions of dollars taken out of Binance and Coinbase by consumers, and various companies and funds go under as their assets were frozen on FTX. And while crypto enthusiasts were quick to point out the limits of the contagion, in 2023, we'll see the beginnings of a crypto ice age that's longer and deeper than any crypto winter before. Regardless of what you think of crypto as a technical marvel, greed has been the killer app fueling crypto's meteoric rise. And the deflation of this runs so much deeper than just FTX. Interest in DeFi will slow to a crawl. A lot of the virtual wallet companies will recede into the background, and the crypto companies that survive will focus on niche but real utilities like digital art, or find ways to serve traditional Web2 companies. But for many of the mainstream outside of crypto, the FTX crash may ultimately be most remembered for what it revealed about our media.
Sam Bankman-Fried is neither a visionary nor a criminal mastermind. He is a human who made the same poor choice that generations of money managers have made before him. Are you effing kidding me?
While the media is supposed to be a check on authority and power, it's becoming ever clearer that consumers are going to have to play a more active role in seeking the truth in the years to come. And it's also becoming clear that social media may not be coming to the rescue. Facebook is sliding into irrelevance for Gen Z, while Zuck is betting the future of the company and tens of billions of dollars on a speculative vision of VR. Meanwhile, Twitter is being carved up by Elon, and creators are looking for an exit door. And yet, this chaos is a ladder for consumer startups. Looking at the App Store in the US today, 4 of the top 6 free apps are new from startups, all focusing on a new game-changing technology called generative AI. If you've logged into any social media platform, you've probably seen pictures of your friends reimagined as princesses, astronauts, or anime characters. Apps like Lenza use generative AI to machine render digital portraits based on uploaded selfies. But this is just scratching the surface of what's possible with generative AI. Machines are creating 3D flybys just from static 2D pictures, and even allowing people to automatically generate music videos or entire virtual worlds just from a text prompt. And through ChatGPT, machines are even writing college admission essays and translating text into Excel formulas or putting together entire PowerPoint presentations. It's no surprise these generative AI technologies have exploded in popularity. ChatGPT reached 2 million users within moments after launch. When Stable Diffusion 2 was released, developer adoption outpaced what revolutionary technologies like Ethereum took years to do in just a matter of days. But this is just the beginning of the coming generative AI revolution. Gaming, in particular, will see an incredible unlock through generative AI. Games are the most complex form of entertainment today, requiring different creative assets from 2D art, 3D models, textures, sound effects, music, characters, animations, and cinematics. But generative AI models are gunning for all of those assets. OpenAI released Point E, which generates 3D models automatically from a picture. Others are automating visual effects, as well as music from text prompts. By the end of 2023, it'll be possible to use text to generate any asset needed to make a game. And this will unlock creativity like we've never seen. As generative AI implodes the cost of producing game assets to nothing, any franchise can convert their IP into ever-complex games, like a Disney MOBA or a BTS Fortnite-style survival game. In the past, the next big game often came from player mods, like Dota, which spawned League of Legends, or DayZ, which spawned PUBG. This game modding could also be turbocharged by generative AI. With so many more games, it's possible that these closed walls between games finally starts breaking down, and you see the emergence of a common identity layer where you can port assets between games. And the games themselves will have increasingly human-like, non-playable characters that will fool us. This phenomenon already occurs in games like bots in Call of Duty or cheater bots in chess, but the next generation of these bots will take human-like to a whole new level. Startups like InWorld AI are making in-game characters that can actually understand the game state and react appropriately with emotions, conversations, animations. Imagine walking through World of Warcraft, not knowing whether or not your clan mage is a bot. Visiting a town without knowing whether the local farmer is human or not. In fact, AI can already play Minecraft, as well as beat humans in complex games like poker, Go, and even advanced negotiation games like Risk that require collaboration and even bluffing other human beings. And as these chatbots and natural language models scale, entire trillion-dollar industries will be reinvented in the most transformative shift since mobile or the cloud. Much of what happens in our workplace is just pushing around language. Legal contracts, code, invoices, and email. This year, more and more programming tools will include automated coding integrations like GitHub Copilot built on top of OpenAI. One day soon, data analysts will type in a query like you would into Google Search and have that converted into a SQL query for a BI tool. Companies like Jasper and CopyAI have already started automating sales emails and marketing copy. Core enterprise resource planning systems help run some of the biggest trillion-dollar industries from manufacturing to healthcare. They're incredibly old school, but also sticky because they don't work well with any other systems. A better understanding of what data fields actually mean within ERP systems may finally allow startups to pipe out that data, instrument better decision-making, and unlock innovation in these historically tech-lagging industries. Within cybersecurity, AI could conduct mock hacks and search for critical security breaches. It wouldn't be a surprise if that customer support rep you speak with would be replaced entirely with voice and NLP in the coming year. Google Search, the greatest monopoly in tech, might start to be displaced by interactive, language-native chatbots. And at Google itself, the Lambda chatbot actually convinced one of its users that it was sentient. Writing and art will be augmented by AI. If you hit writer's block, AI might suggest your next sentence. And one day soon, language models should be good enough to write end-to-end novels, poems, and songs. Increasingly, your health diagnosis might be done by AI rather than a doctor. And you might even take legal advice from a robo-lawyer. It's going to be wild to see how automation, which drives labor costs to zero, might completely implode some of today's manual, human-driven businesses. Tutoring, for example, is prohibitively expensive for most people, but ChatGPT may democratize this for the rest of the world. Credit counseling is also something typically too expensive for those who need it, and is often subsidized by nonprofits. But the ability of ChatGPT to take input and deliver near-human quality advice changes all of this, especially for things like simple financial questions or academic subjects for kids. But the sheer power of AI and its rapid acceleration will also force us to contend with serious questions. That includes the potential explosion of soulless chatbot-driven content online. ChatGPT can often sound credible, but otherwise be completely devoid of fact, particularly problematic with things like medical advice. ChatGPT has also become a powerful tool for kids to cheat on homework or even write college admissions essays. Maybe most disturbing, AI blurs the boundaries on identity and personal digital rights as it becomes easier to impersonate other people convincingly.
I am not Morgan Freeman, and what you see is not real.
But the biggest breakthrough of the year might actually be in climate tech. Scientists at the Lawrence Livermore Lab replicated nuclear fission, the process that powers the sun. They used almost 200 lasers to heat a tiny pellet of hydrogen plasma to more than 180 million degrees Fahrenheit. The hydrogen atoms then fused together and released more energy than it took to start the reaction. While the process only lasted 100 trillionths of a second, it nonetheless has groundbreaking implications. Could we one day replicate the sun's limitless and zero carbon source of energy here on Earth? That would be the holy grail. And while it may take decades to operationalize this, the journey to doing so starts this year. Maybe even more unbelievable, this year we'll continue to advance towards the never-ending quest for humans to stay young and live forever. A number of startups are pioneering research into how we might reverse the aging process and even deactivate death itself. Through cellular reprogramming, genetic editing and gene therapy, anti-aging drugs, and even body part replacement and mind uploading.
This may sound like science fiction, but in maybe the most uplifting and miraculous scientific breakthrough of 2022, a 13-year-old girl with incurable leukemia was given T cells genetically modified by CRISPR technology to target her own cancerous cells. And this therapy actually cured her. There's hope this will generalize to other forms of cancer, and if it does, it will be a generational discovery. The real-life cure for cancer may just be around the corner.
The metaverse had a tough year. Even while Facebook rebranded the entire company around the concept, usage was embarrassingly low and they couldn't even get their own employees to use it. But it's actually becoming really interesting for some kinds of work. while you and I might not find it worth it to shell out hundreds of dollars for the quest. That's Chump Change for a medical device company trying to educate surgeons on the complexity of the many new procedures constantly coming to market. And for these surgeons, training in a visual environment, just like pilots have been doing for decades, is a lot better than trying to read hundreds of pages of technical PDF guides or operating on cadavers. This coming year, the metaverse will become the place not where you and I meet up with friends, but where highly skilled professionals get real work done. If you zoom out, civilization's greatest technological achievements have segmented our history into eras, like the Stone or Iron Ages and the Industrial Revolution. Today, we're entering the Space Age, and there's a new arms race for extraterrestrial, industrial, and military power. We all know companies like SpaceX are building advanced rockets and satellites, but there's the beginnings of a bigger intergalactic supply chain being constructed from the ground up. This is everything from manufacturing and launching on Earth to new infrastructure in space to service existing assets in orbit and power more ambitious missions to deep space. Varda is even manufacturing computer chips in space with higher precision and quality than is possible on Earth given the absence of gravity and dust particles. In the coming year, a number of emerging startups will vie to be part of the new space industrial base. But let's bring it back to Earth now. What's actually going to happen in the broader tech ecosystem? The Fed will finally tame inflation this year, but at the cost of higher interest rates than we anticipated. And that will hit growth areas like tech the heaviest. As a result, fundraising for startups will continue to trickle in, but at much lower prices than the first half of 2022. While a few hot businesses in trendy areas like AI will raise at crazy multiples, the majority of startups that have enough runway will skip fundraising altogether and wait out the downturn. The others in the messy middle will be forced to reprice in flat or down rounds. Capital-intensive industries with long pathways to commercialization, like autonomous driving vehicles, some robotics, and other deep tech, will feel the most pain. But at the end of the day, there's no bear market for innovation. It's easy to get lost in the pessimism of a year like 2022 where so much went wrong. But if you had bet on innovation through every downturn from the 1990s oil shock to the dot-com bubble to the Great Recession, you would have made out a tremendous winner. Innovation doesn't care and waits for no one. It's remarkable to see tech innovation even transforming the way YouTubers run their channels as entrepreneurs. In fact, MrBeast may be on a path to becoming the next Elon Musk. Check out this video to learn what he's doing to make that a reality. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time.